When the war in Iraq started, I was very opposed to it, I have to tell you. And I came out and it was very strong that I was opposed to it. And now I get, you know, I used to take a little heat on that, but now I get a lot of credit for it. But in 2003, 2004, I said, if you do that, you're going to destabilize the Middle East. It's going to be a disaster. One or the other, whoever we're going to knock out, because we can knock them out pretty easily, is going to take over. The one that's not knocked out is going to take over. So we knock out Iraq. Iran is taking over the Middle East. We have totally destabilized the Middle East. And I said this in 2004. We have totally destabilized the Middle East. It's a disaster. And you look at this new Iran deal, which took forever to get done. You look at how bad it is and how one-sided it is. You look at how one-sided this deal is. And yesterday I heard we're getting our hostages back. Some people call them prisoners. Some people call them hostages. I don't care. So we're getting them back. And then I heard, well, wait a minute, we're paying a big price. They're getting seven back. We're getting actually four. You know, they say five, but the other one they can't find, he's in Iran. I tell you what, that's a strange, that's another thing we're going to be looking into. And we're getting four back. They're getting seven. They're getting 14 off of the Interpol watch list. These are real bad customers. They're getting all sorts of advantages, including free market oil. They're getting unbelievable advantages. They're going to be an immensely wealthy country and a wealthy terror country, and they're getting $150 billion. So when our sailors were captured last week, I said, that's one of the saddest things that I've seen. When those young people were on their hands and knees in a begging position with their hands up and thugs behind them with guns, and then we talk like it's okay. It's not okay. It's lack of respect. We can't let that happen to this country. It's lack of respect. And we're not going to let it happen to this country. We're going to be strong. We're going to be vigilant. We're going to have powerful borders and strong borders. And look what just happened this morning. I don't know, for any of you that have been seeing the news or reading the news, three people have just been kidnapped in Iraq because they see, what the heck? We pay $150 billion for four people, three people just this morning, and this is going to take place all over. They should have come back as part of the deal 3 years ago when they started talking about the deal. Not now. Not now. And what should have happened is our representatives, first of all, we needed people that negotiate properly, not a guy like Kerry who doesn't have a clue. But, and we will have those people. I know those people. We will have those people. But when you look at what went on, our people, all you had to do is go in and say to the Persians, very good negotiators, great negotiators, legendary negotiators, they're known for it. They're sitting across the table. Fellas, and in this case it is all fellas, I hate to tell you to the women, they're behind the fact. They're a little behind the fact. They haven't figured out that women maybe in certain ways are much better than men, but I don't want to say that because I'll get myself in trouble with men. But they haven't figured this out yet, but that's okay. You say, fellas, we want our prisoners back. Got to have them back. Doesn't help you, helps us. We'll make a better deal. The United States, the people, they want them back. They're talking about them. We want our prisoners back. Got to give them back. They'll say no. And we'll say, that's okay. Don't worry about it. Bye-bye. Get up. Leave the room. Now you double up the sanctions. Within 48 hours, they will call and they'll say, we want our prisoners back. And here's your prisoners. And now you go in a second time. You don't mention this. You say, listen, the other thing I had to tell you, but I didn't want to tell you before we got our prisoners back, we're not going to give you any money. No money. We don't have it. We're a debtor nation. We owe $19 trillion. We're not going to give you any money. And you want to be nice. You don't want to put it in their face. Just say, look, we're a poor nation. We've been mismanaged. We've been misrun. We don't know what the hell we're doing. Right? Is that true or what? This isn't Jerry running our nation, that I can tell you. But we've been mismanaged. We don't know what we're doing. We have $19 trillion in debt, going to be 21 because that ridiculous budget that was approved last week, which got approved so fast, that's going to add another $2 trillion. So we're going to be $21 trillion. So we say, we can't give it to you. Don't have it. Sorry. And they'll probably be upset, but don't worry about it. A week will go by, they'll say, let's start negotiating. So you could have saved, you could have gotten the prisoners out years ago for nothing. for nothing, without giving them these people, who, by the way, deserve to have been in prison. These were serious. And the Interpol people, forget it. These are bad dudes. These are bad people. So they made, like, this incredible deal. But everybody makes good deals with the United States because the world is smart, and they use their smart people, and they use their most cunning, streetwise people, and they know what they're doing. We have people that don't know what they're doing. We want to be politically correct, like Jerry Sr. would say, politically correct. We want to be politically correct. And it's just not working. And I